All right, Charles, let's see what you think.
The first one says we want to have a fixed number of clusters. Well, actually, the first thing I'll note about that is since we're going to have a fixed number of clusters, it doesn't have the richness property.
Good point.
Because richness would allow for one cluster, or could have n clusters, or could have n over three clusters, or could have n over two clusters. But here, you forced it to always have n over two clusters, so it can't represent all possible clusterings.
Agreed.
However, you'll notice that there's nothing in here that cares about distances, in the sense that if I took all of the points and I multiplied their distances by two, I would still get the same clusters in exactly the same order.
That's the important thing, that it cares about distances, but it only cares about the order, not the scale.
Exactly. So that means there's scale invariance.
Very good.
And then by the same argument, this algorithm has consistency, because the points that were clustered together, if they got closer together, they would still be picked up. And the ones that were farther apart, well, they'd still get picked up by each other, and it doesn't matter. So they're definitely consistent.
That's right. And that's a nice little property of singling clustering. Let's move on to the second clustering algorithm.
Nice. Okay, so clusters that are theta units apart. Well, since theta can change, even if theta is fixed, the points that I get could be various kinds of distances. So let's imagine that theta was 10 feet. If all the points are within 10 feet of one another, then they would be one cluster.
Yep.
If, on the other hand, all the points were more than 10 feet apart, you would have n different clusters, and you could do any of them in between. So this is rich.
It is indeed. That's right. We can always muck with the units, or muck with theta for that matter, so that we can group, we can make any number of clusters in any combination that we want.
Yeah, but for exactly the same argument that they're rich, they are not scale invariant.
Yeah.
Because I could just take everything and multiply it by theta, multiply the distance by theta, and now I will suddenly have n. And if I had n to begin with, I could divide by theta, and then I would have 1. So it's not scale invariant.
Agreed.
But the consistency argument still works, because all the points that got clustered together, because they were within theta of each other, if I made them closer, would still be within theta of each other. And the ones that weren't clustered together, because they were more than theta apart, would now be even more than theta apart. And so you do get consistency.
Agreed.
Excellent. Okay.
All right. Last example.
Clusters that are theta W units apart where, I'm sorry, theta omega units apart.
theta divided by omega.
Where omega equals the maximum distance. Well, that's just a way of normalizing distance. In much the same way that I argued for richness for the second algorithm, the same argument applies here.
That it is rich.
It is rich, because I can keep just shrinking and moving the points around, and it'll work out just fine. So it's definitely rich.
We don't control omega, because that's determined by the distances, but we can change the theta so that things are too close or too far. Yeah, okay, I agree with that.
Well, that's sort of the last thing you said for the second algorithm, too. So you do get richness. Now, what's interesting to me here is that, unlike in the second algorithm where you didn't have scale invariance, you do get scale invariance here, because if I try to make things bigger, I'm also going to make the maximum distance bigger by exactly the same amount, and so I will always end up back where I was before.
Yeah, so whatever you do to scale this, it's going to get undone. Yeah, very good.
Right, exactly. Anything I do to make them farther apart will just make them the same distance, at least by omega.
Agreed. Okay, and if we have consistency too, we've got a trifecta.
We do, except we don't have consistency.
What?
Because if I make the clusters that are farther apart, I also change omega.
And that could actually change the cluster.
It would, because, in fact, imagine that I made the points in a set of clusters much closer together, but then I move that cluster, you know, sort of infinitely far apart from the rest of the clusters. Then suddenly my theta divided by infinity or near infinity would make the radius of allowable clusters so small that no points would be able to cluster with any other point. And so that would screw up whatever you had before, assuming you had clusters before at all. And so I can construct a world where consistency would be wrong. Oh, that's nice. It made a little diagonal of X's.
And I win 3 in a row.
Well done, Michael. So what little tweak do we have to do to one of these algorithms in order to get me a trifecta?
Yeah, it would be great, wouldn't it? And that's the final algorithm that we'll talk about.
Great.